First off, congratulations, Mr. Gradovich, on an incredible fight. You took this fight on short notice. Were you ever hesitant about your lack of a full training camp coming into this fight?
So I got the fight 1 month ago. I thought about this fight 2 days, and when my manager asked me when I want I fight this fight, I say yes. After 2 days, I thought about that, but you know, it was short but very
short but very high preparation.
Yes,
so
yes.
He had little time, but he worked his ass off for that little time.
Because I have small time for preparation, small time for sleep. I got good sleep only last night, you know. I'm very happy right now. I'm world champion. I believe in myself. And I did it. No, I did it. We did it. My team, my manager, my promoter, my trainer Robert Garcia, my friends, everybody who support me. We did it, everybody.
So what's next for you now? Because you're a champion.
You know, I'm very tired today. And let me rest, please. And we're gonna see what we're gonna do.
Mm-hmm. Now, Robert, you have two featherweight title holders now in your gym. How big of an accomplishment is that? You basically have the featherweight market cornered.
Well, we have a great team. You know, it's not just myself. You know, we have a team with every one of my fighters. It's a teamwork, and you know, it's just awesome to know that we have this kind of champions and guys that dedicate themselves to the sport. They deserve it. You know. Gradovich is one of the perfect example of somebody that deserves to be world champion and get big fights, because he trains very hard. He's very humble. He came to my gym to become world champion, and now he is a world champion.
I mean, tell me about that, going into the fight with Dib. We knew Dib was awkward. Did you ever? What were your thoughts going into the fight?
Well, as soon as they told us about the fight, you know, Gradovich thought about it one or two days before he made the decision. But right away, I said, you know, this is a fight that we could take. Our team, we decided let's take this fight, because Billy Dib is a perfect style, perfect opponent to become world champion, especially the way Gradovich fights. It's a perfect style to become a world champion.
The only two fighters who have now beaten Billy Dib have been trained by you. But was that something that you knew in your head, that you know you figured him out before you can do it again?
Not at all. You know, since then it's been a while since Stevie Leone beat him, and Billy Dib came to become a world champion and defense started a couple times, so he became a better fighter. So no, we prepared for the new Billy Dib that was a world champion.
What are you thinking about next with this man right here? You have, like I was saying, two featherweight title holders. Is there anyone else out there that you would like to see Gradovich against?
You know, he's got a great great manager, great promoter, so that's their job. My job is to train my fighters, and I don't make decisions who they fight. It's up to his manager and his promoter.
So, you're trainer of the year for last year. Are you trying to get a jump start on this year now?
Well, it's not that I'm trying. It's my fighters are doing the job. You know, my fighters are winning, and they keep they keep doing their job, and you know, my team is working, and you know, we're just a family, and that the results are there. You know, two world champions in about a month and a half apart
in the same division too,
and then you know, we just got the rest of the year with great fights coming up, so hopefully we just continue doing what we've been doing for the past.
See ya.